Hello students, we are going to start chapter 12, sound. Production of sound. How sound is produced? Sound is produced by the vibration of particles present in the object. That is, the to and fro rapid movement of an object about a fixed point is called as vibration. So what is vibration? Vibration is nothing but the to and fro movement of an object. An object which moves to and fro and it is fixed at a point is called as vibration. So sound is produced by vibration of particles of present in the object. For example, take a rubber band and stretch the rubber band and leave it. This will set the rubber band into vibration. When you leave it, you will see that rubber band starts vibrating and you can hear a sound. So this is vibration. Now, how the sound is produced in the human beings? Human beings have a structure called as voice box or larynx in the neck region that help us to produce sound when we talk. So we have a voice box, a structure called as voice box in the neck that helps in producing of the sound. This voice box has a membrane tissue called as vocal cords. They have a tissue called as vocal cord, which has a small slit. Small slit means narrow opening, small opening between them for the passage of the air. They have a small hole through which the air can pass. The vocal cords are held by the muscles that control the vibration of the cords. So these vocal cords are held by the muscles that controls the vibration. Now, while talking or making the sound, air enters the windpipe. The air causes the vocal cord to vibrate. And this vibration of the vocal cords produces the sound. In this way, the sound is produced in the human beings. When you touch your neck, you can feel the vibrations also. Next, oscillations. What are oscillations? The to and fro motion of an object. When an object moves to and fro, for example, swing. The swing moves to and fro. That is called as oscillation. That is the to and fro motion of an object. Next, amplitude of an oscillation. The maximum displacement of a pendulum bob from its mean position. Mean position is the rest position when pendulum is at rest. When you pull the bob, that is the maximum distance which it takes. That is called as amplitude from its mean position. The maximum displacement of the pendulum of bob from the mean position is called amplitude of the oscillation. It is denoted by the letter A. Next, time period. The time taken by the bob to complete one oscillation. So how much time it has taken to complete one oscillation is called as time period. It is denoted by letter T. Next, frequency. What is frequency? The number of oscillations completed in 1 second. In 1 second, how many oscillations have been completed by the bob, that is pendulum, is called frequency and it is denoted by letter F. The SI unit of frequency, we call it as hertz, that is HZ. Characteristics of sound. What are characteristics of sound? Sound travels as a wave. So sound waves, we say sound waves. So sound travels in the form of waves. It is characterized by the loudness, pitch and quality. So next characteristic is, it is characterized by its loudness. How loud the sound is, how high the pitch is, and what is the quality of sound. It is the characteristic. And sound is caused by the vibration. So sound is always produced by the vibration. Now, what is loudness? Loudness is the perception in the ear which helps to identify the low intense and high intense sound. So it is the perception in the ear that helps to identify that the voice which is coming is of low intense or a high intense sound. Amplitude. Amplitude determines the loudness of the sound. How? That is the maximum distance that the sound has covered in the wave. An amplitude increases, then the loudness of the sound increases. If the amplitude is maximum, if the amplitude is more, then the loudness will also be more. If the amplitude is less, the loudness is also less. If you're talking slowly, the amplitude is less. If you're talking loudly, the amplitude is more. Next, pitch. The shrillness of the sound experienced by the listener is called as pitch. Okay, the shrillness. Shrillness is nothing but the vibration experienced by the listener is called as pitch. As the frequency of sound increases, pitch also increases. If the frequency is more, the pitch is more. Propagation of sound. How the sound waves travel. How the sound wave propagate. Sound wave travels in the form of waves. This we know that the sound waves travel in the form of waves. We hear a sound when the waves reaches our ear. How we hear the sound? The waves, when they reach to our ears, we hear the sound. These sound waves can travel through solid, liquid, gases. Unlike light, sound cannot travel through vacuum. Unlike light, the sound cannot travel through vacuum. When the sound is produced by vibrating body, it transfers its energy to the molecule of the medium. This air molecule then starts vibrating. In turn, they transfer the energy to the neighboring molecules and so on. So, when the sound is produced by a vibrating body, it transfers the energy to the molecules of the medium. Suppose now I am talking. These sound waves transfers the energy to the molecule in the ear. They starts vibrating, and these air molecules starts vibrating, and then they transfer to the energy to the other neighboring molecule and so on. When sound wave propagate through the medium, the particles in the medium do not move from one place to another. They just vibrate about their mean position. So now if I am talking, what happens? Energy, the sound wave is coming in the, it is coming in the form of energy. It will hit the molecule which is present in front. It starts vibrating, and this vibrating molecules make the other molecules also vibrate. In this way, the sound wave is produced. Now, how do the human hears the sound? We hear the sound through an organ called as ear. Ear is an organ of the human body that help us to hear the sound. We can classify the parts of ear as outer ear, middle ear and inner ear. So ear is classified into three parts: outer ear, middle ear and inner ear. Outer ear, it consists of ear flap or external ear called as pinna. An ear canal which directs the sound to the eardrum. So outer ear receives the sound waves, and these sound waves are passed through the outer ear into the eardrum. It touches the eardrum. When it touches the eardrum is stretched membrane like our skin drum. So it acts as the interface to the outer ear and in middle ear. Next, middle ear. It is an air-filled column with three tiny interconnected bones. Okay, it has three interconnected. Interconnected means all the three bones are connected to each other. Incus, malleus and stapes. Inner ear. It has three parts: cochlea, semicircular canals and auditory nerves. Okay, inner ear have three parts. Middle ear have three bones. And outer ear is having the ear flaps, that is called as pinna. The pinna collects the sound from the outside channel it to the middle ear and transfer it to the middle ear. The bones of the middle ear vibrates when the sound wave hits the middle ear, it starts vibrating. and amplify the sound and transfer it to the inner ear. From the outer ear, it goes to the middle ear. From the middle ear, middle ear starts vibrating and transfers it to the inner ear. The parts of the inner ear have a sound sensitive cells. They have a sound sensitive cell that receives the amplified vibration. So they have a cells, sensitive cells. These specialized cells start vibrating, and these vibrations are converted into nerve impulse, which are carried to the brain for interpretation. So first, our outer ear collects all the sound. From the outer ear, it is transferred into the middle ear. When it touches the middle ear, the middle ear starts vibrating and transfers it into the inner ear. In inner ear, they have sensitive cells. They have the sound sensitive cells which detect the sound, and they start vibrating and change it into nerve impulse. And when the nerve impulse, these nerve impulse are carried to the brain for interpretation that what the other person is speaking. Reflection of sound. When sound waves falls on the surface, they bounce back from the surface. This phenomena is called as reflection of sound. So when sound waves fall on any surface, they bounce back, they come back. So this phenomena is called as reflection of sound. Echo occurs due to reflection of sound by the hills or the walls of the building. Sometimes you hear the double sound, that is called as an echo. Okay, that is due to the reflection of sound. When the sound waves are hitting the surface, they bounce back. They bounce back from the surface. Then you hear the sound. That is reflection of sound. Now, types of sound. Sound can be classified on the basis of auditory of the sound to the humans. The sound of frequency below 20 hertz and above 20,000 hertz cannot be heard by the human being. So human beings can hear in between 20 to 20,000 hertz. Below 20,000 hertz, the sound of frequency below 20 hertz is called as infrasonic sounds. And the sound wave more than 20,000 hertz are called as ultrasonic sound. So we can hear only the frequency, the range of frequency of the human ear is 20 to 20,000 hertz. The sound of frequency less than 20 hertz are called as infrasonic, and the sound frequency more than 20,000 hertz are called as ultrasonic sounds. Human ear are sensitive only to the sound waves with a frequency of 20 to 20,000 hertz. Sound waves which gives a pleasant feeling are usually called as musical sound. Means which gives us a good feeling, pleasant feeling are called as musical sound, and the sound which produce unpleasant and irritating feeling are called as noise. Pleasant sounds are the sound which is produced by the birds or any speakers. They are pleasant sound, and the sound which are produced by the horns or through any machineries, they are unpleasant sound which gives an unpleasant and irritating feel. They are called as noise. Noise pollution and its harmful effect. Too much of noise in the surroundings is harmful and leads to the noise pollution. Sound produced by the running vehicles, horns, various devices we use which in our daily life, like vacuum cleaner, drilling machine, mixer grinder, are some of the major cause of the noise pollution. Long exposure to the noise pollution, polluted environment can lead to some health problem, serious health problem. That is, long exposure to the noise can reduce the concentration and cause the restlessness. It can also cause the frequent headache or hearing problem. Noise pollution leads to increased heartbeat. Sudden exposure to very high level of the noise may lead to the temporary or even a permanent hearing disability. Exposure to the high noise may lead to the sleep disturbance and discomfort. These are the harmful effects of the noise pollution. Now, how to reduce the noise pollution? So we can reduce the noise pollution by avoiding the loud music which will hurt you as well as others' ears. So avoid the loud music. Plant more and more trees to reduce noise level. because the plants and the trees have good ability to absorb the sound. Avoid unnecessary use of horns of the vehicles while traveling. Wear earplugs to protect the ear if working in the noisy atmosphere. Minimize the use of defective machines and engines which produce unwanted sounds. Okay, these are the methods to reduce the noise pollution. Till here, your chapter has been completed. Thank you.